Hey everybody, it's Drogoth here, and I am bringing you a special matchup. It is between Gazarzgo as the, what are you, Teal? You're a Teal Zerg player in the 9 o'clock position, and we have Ulrazaj, or as I like to call him, Jazz, as the Blue Protoss player in the 6 o'clock position, and they're just having fun right now, talking back and forth. Both of them are in the Einherjar Guild with myself. Murderface is gonna come on, so I gotta actually, please ignore this. There we go. So there we go. Fix that real quick. Just so that it looks like I'm busy. Anyways, both of these guys are in Einherjar with me. They both outrank me a lot. And it's fun to see what these two guys do, especially since I see Gaz all the time. You know, doing these replays, you've seen plenty of replays by him as well. And Jazz is a new guy to the he's not new to the guild. He's new to any of these replays. So Gaz actually sent me this one, not Jazz. So it's gonna be kind of fun to watch. Jazz is actually like wicked awesome at computers. By the way, I'm from near Boston. Wicked means really, in case you didn't know that. So if it's wicked awesome, it is really Austin. Austin. Wicked. Awesome. And now you've just got Bostonian 101. The other thing is pissa. Pissa is good. Why? Not because you're urinating, because something wicked pissa is really awesome. Anyways, let's get on to this. We are on Lost Temple. Very classic map. Brought in from StarCraft 1. Jazz, is he doing that extractor trick that we just talked about? No, I don't see. Let's look. Nope, takes a second. Okay. So, no, there's an extractor trick that's not an extractor trick, a resource gather, be drone, probe, SCV, whatever, that's going out right now. I think Ask Joshy did a little video about. No, it wasn't Joshy. I don't remember, did it? It was either Joshy or Anaris that pointed it out. But it did a nice little video commentary on it. And what you do is when a harvester is coming back, this little carry icon comes up, and you shift right click, you know, on here. Just keep on shifting and right clicking. And what happens is you cue him up to move really fast. So as soon as those minnows pop in his hand, he moves instead of that 1 second pause. Ready, comes up. Right there, he would move automatically. Apparently you get like 7%, but it is really macro intensive. Gaz is going for the Roach Warn right now. Just kind of felt like going back into the game. And Jazz actually blocked himself off. So he's got a probe over here, not really doing anything. Completely blocked off his ramp. He's queuing up Zealots. What's wrong with you? This has got to be a new game. My wife's making fun of me. She's cooking. Our new move-in neighbor is here too. They've been drinking. It's funny. Anyways, Roach is out. Not really gonna do too much. Oh, nice fast expansion going up by Gaz. But you know, pulling up a couple of units. Gonna do some really good damage against these Zealots if he decides to do a little push out. And again, like I was saying, Jazz just kind of blocked off his ramp. Can't really get through there. Forge is coming up, so he might be dropping a forge over here. Maybe get rid of that Overlord. Just try and get out of the ramp. I have a feeling this is gonna be slow pace. So take your time. Cybercore going down, about halfway done. And there's that cannon that I was talking about. And 1, 2, 3 roaches coming over. I would have waited for 4 roaches to come out. There's number 4, 5, and 6. Okay, yeah, so he's doing pretty good. However, with that cannon coming up in a second, he's going to have to get in there before that cannon goes down, or at least attack the pylon. That zealot does go down, and these guys can't attack that pylon. You got to get to that pylon. There's no zealots up here. Creep up that ramp. What's wrong with you, Gaz? Creep up that ramp, because now that that pylon's out there, your overlord is going to get taken out, and you can just sit here and keep him in his base, and he could probably pump up to Void Rays if he was any good. I just want to look at the income tab really quick. 24 probes for Jazz, so he's doing a macro machine kind of build, and 16 for Gaz. 16 drones, not 16 probes. It'd be really funny if he had 16 probes. Zerg with probes. I guess Well, you probably could. Yeah, you could do it with an infester. You know, grab a probe, build a nexus, rinse, recycle, repeat. You know, get out a couple of probes, yada yada yada. Then you get carriers. There's nothing better than having a whole bunch of carriers teamed up with a a whole bunch of broodlords. That'd be kind of sexy. Yes, sexy like a man wearing pants. Haha. Because, well, you know, because as we all know, a man wearing pants is not sexy at all. A man without pants is quite sexy. I don't know. This is just fun. But anyways, we do have the Stargate coming up, so it looks like Jazz was going initially for that the Void Ray build. He was just kind of delaying it a little bit with these forces out in the front. A couple of Banelings could really tear this guy up right now. A couple of them would get taken out. If he aimed right at these pylons, though, he could take those out and completely nuke all these buildings and then just take all those guys out. Anyways, Void Ray coming out, and my wife and her friend are arguing over beer, which is better, Budweiser or Heineken. And they're pretty much both. Oh, you have to hear this. If you can hear this conversation, it's great. It says Anheuser-Busch. Okay, so we got a Spire coming up by Jazz. Or by Gaz. Gaz and Jazz, yeah. It's the Jeezy. It's the Jizza, the Kizza. Anyways, so the countering for these Void Rays, Gaz making good moves, seeing that it was blocked off, knowing that pretty much establishing that Jazz is going to be going Void Rays. He goes right to Mutas, which is a great counter for these Void Rays. They do tons of little damage, and you can easily microwave a Muta once he starts getting lower. The charge starts getting going on, it can run away. Definitely has more speed than the Void Ray can handle without the upgrades. We do actually have three Stargates on one base. You can't do that, Jazz. You're oversaturated. See these guys going back and forth? You need to... 30... Yeah, you got 30 guys. You're oversaturated just a little bit. You should actually drop down like a Robocore. Pick up a Warp Prism, pick up a Probe, drop them down here, drop them somewhere else. Just expand a little bit, because as it is, Gaz, he's starting to expand around the horseshoe right here, and he's going to out-macro you, man. Doesn't even matter with micro right now, he's just going to out-macro you, and we do have Mutas finally on the board, Warp Gate Research being done, and Gleeron's Reconstitution and the Flyers. Alright, so I don't know why Gaz sent this to me, this was really slow. I'm going to have a bunch of comments, this is tons of macro right here. Anyways, well, it is good to see, you know, Jazz doing this. This is a pointer right here. Three gateways. One set of minerals. No. Bad. Is mounting up his Void Rays over here. I might be thinking that it is Brood Wars again. She's calling Heineken to ask them which is better, Budweiser or Heineken. Christine Hunt, I don't think they have a 24-hour hotline. So, she's drunk dialing Heineken, and I'm sorry, you guys. I wish I had a mic like set up in here. Void Rays are going to attack, and here come these Mutas. They're going to be doing some damage, like I was talking about. That spread damage going on. Let's see if you can see how this goes. One guy's going down. Gaz forgot to make Hydras. Yes, you did forget to make Hydras, but you do have two other bases. So Jazz is going to be hurting Gaz really bad, but for some reason Gaz is not getting his guys out of there. He does have, you know, three Mutas. Three Mutas aren't really going to do much against these Void Rays. I don't know what the heck he's doing. Three of them coming in, and one, two, three more coming in, so there's six of them coming in. Nice little splash damage going on. One more goes down, but at the cost of one, two, three, four, not even another one comes down, although these guys are taken down pretty good. So half of the Void Ray is taken out by, I believe it was 12? Yeah, I think it was 12 of the mutas, and at the same time, Jazz is continually to pump out the Void Rays for Gaz to counter. Somehow, do we have a Hydralisk Den? We do have a Hydralisk Den coming down right over there. Do we have any Hydras coming out? We have 11 Hydras coming out with the Groove Spines coming out. There's three of them. We should have two more, so the other ones are right up there. They're going to be coming down here, and they're just going to cause some serious pain on these Void Rays. As soon as they come in here, the Queen's going to come over. They completely lost their charge, so they're not going to be doing much damage. And here come those Hydras, and look at that damage just go down. You add even more of those to the mix. And here we go, Jazz is running away as Gazargo is chasing him down. And once he gets off the creep, nice and slow Hydras. Look at that, they're the same speed. So anyways, we did have a nice little battle over here. Gaz did lose one of his bases over. He did keep three cocoons before the larva died. He is moving them over to his first expansion. The second expansion is doing pretty well itself with the Hydra Den going down. Nothing really coming out as he's extremely gas heavy. And nothing really on the minerals. Maybe taking these guys off of these gas for a second just to get something out would be a good idea by Gaz. On the other side, Jazz is blowing up the gold rocks, and he doesn't have a robo down, so I don't know. He's going to have to explode one of these pylons, and I'm going to guess that cannon right there just to be able to get one of the guys out. And he is accounting even more Void Rays up, or he's getting even more Void Rays up. We do have the Hydras coming around. One of them does go down from a single cannon fire.